I have no idea at what point that stopped recording. So, Albino stock.
Had to do some drill mill stuff here to make it where the trigger guard could come off.
It's okay. It's not my favorite. I wish there were more options in this shotgun. I really do. She's really, really good. And I do really wish that... I wish I had the aftermarket options for furniture the way you do with like a Remington 870. Granted, obviously there's not anywhere near as many Beretta 1301s in the world, so... She cycles everything I put through her that's lethal. An excellent shotgun. I bought this one for $650. The stock on it's about $750. I'm gonna get the magazine adapter from somebody, the people that Beretta use. Nordic. I give the stock 7 out of 10. I shouldn't have to Dremel shit off and I'll be able to take my trigger guard out. It needs upper locators as well as lower locators to fit into that square to hold it perfectly locked in. It doesn't seem to have any wobble, but it's just not in there the way I'd like it to be in there. It's not in there the way the Beretta stock's in there. And I understand that this got this piece here, but you could still notch out of the square and have this piece and have the male square to go into the female square. She's an excellent shotgun. This Beano stock is worth it. I just wish there were other options. Preferably something with a collapsible option. Yeah, I know Mesa Tactical makes that. It is weird and I don't like it. I have it. Personal preference, but I don't like it. She runs wet, she runs light, she runs buck, she runs... I haven't shot slugs through it, but I'm assuming they're going to run just fine because, well, everything else has. It's an excellent shotgun, guys.
I dig it.